That was Michael Jordan, the player, speaking. And I loved him, maybe to a fault. You can tell me I have no objectivity here. But that, what Michael Jordan just said, that Kerry just read, was the difference between the greatest player that was Michael Jordan and the great player that is LeBron James. LeBron, to me, I'm going to say it again, has entered a new phase of his career. And he has had a great career, no doubt. But if you do the seasons of his career, spring, summer, fall, winter, I think he's sort of into the fall of his career now. He's become a global icon and businessman, as you continue to so beautifully point out day after day after day. This man is a great businessman surrounded by great businessmen. But Michael Jordan, when he was a player, he was a player. And I loved his line about, if you had taken away some of my 82, I'd go play at the park. I'd go play at Tim Grover's gym. I'd just go find a game and I'd play it all day long because he was a basketball player. I always called Michael, when I covered him, a supremely talented overachiever, which I'd never seen before. You always see the overachievers who are a little under-talented and they just do it with guts and guile and grit, all those good things. Michael had all that, but he was supremely gifted to boot. So Michael Jordan, every night, my other line about him was, if you watched him in February on the second game of a back-to-back, he would always do one thing in a game and you'd say, I don't know if I've ever seen that before. And this was in a back-to-back because he loved to play basketball. Not that LeBron doesn't, but LeBron is looking at the big picture. He's now become a leader of the players. Not that he's a leader of the Players Association, but I think he's the unofficial president of the Players Association. And he's speaking in a bigger picture businessman perspective than Michael ever wanted to take. Michael shirked that responsibility. He didn't want to be that guy. He didn't want to be the leader of the players. He wanted to beat all their behinds, and he did. He was like Tiger when Tiger, like Tiger was never a great Ryder Cup player because it's like, I don't want to be your teammate. I want to kick your behind. So that's Michael Jordan, the player, speaking like, seriously? You guys want to play fewer games? If you told Michael, we're going to increase the season to 102 games, he'd be like, bring it, man. Good. I'll have more fun next year. That's just me.